In this tutorial series, I will show you how you can create AI applications using a no-code platform called Langflow. Langflow is open source and free to use, and you do not need any coding experience to follow along. The setup process is really simple, and the tool is fun and easy to use. In this series, you will learn how to create everything from simple chatbots to advanced RAG agents that can answer questions from your own data and also use tools in the process. You will also learn how to deploy your applications and integrate them into websites or custom apps using the Langflow APIs. Langflow is similar to tools like Flowwise, where you have this drag-and-drop interface for building AI applications, but it does offer its own unique set of features, which you will learn during the course of this video. But the primary difference between Langflow and Flowwise is that Langflow is based on the Python programming language, which offers libraries and features that are preferred by data scientists. Langflow also offers components and integration with all the major vendors. So let's get started by setting up Langflow on our own machines. So as per the documentation, all we need is Python 3.10 or greater installed on our machines. So in the description of this video, you will find the link to this Python page. So if you scroll down to files, simply download the installer for your operating system. Since I'm using Windows, I'll download the Windows installer. Go ahead and execute the installer, and at the bottom of this pop-up, be sure to check this add Python to path, and then continue with the installation. Now that we have Python installed, we can go ahead and set up Langflow on our machines. So just something to note, in this video, we will be installing the pre-release version so that I can show you all the latest features. But by the time you watch this video, the standard installation might be sufficient. So I'm just mentioning this because if you do install Langflow using the standard install and you don't see the features that I'm showing you in this video, then rather follow the pre-release installation instructions instead. But as a bonus, I will actually show you the simplest way to get all of the setup by running a simple script. Let's first have a look at doing this manually. Open up a new folder on your machine, and then within that folder, open up the command prompt. In Windows, I can just right-click on this folder and then click on Open in Terminal. Or I can also go to the address bar and enter CMD, and this will open up the command prompt. Then I highly recommend first creating a virtual environment using Python-m space VNV space VNV. On Mac or Linux, I believe you need to enter Python 3. Let's go ahead and run this. Then we need to activate this virtual environment by entering VNV / scripts / activate and enter. You will now notice this prefix which contains the environment name, and this means our virtual environment is currently active. On Mac and Linux, the script does look slightly different, so to activate your virtual environment, enter source venv / bin / activate, and that will activate your virtual environment. We can now go ahead and install Langflow by typing pip install langflow then --- pre, then --- force reinstall. Everything from --- pre all the way to the end is optional, but this is what we'll use to install the pre-release version of Langflow. But by the time you watch this video, this version might be generally available, so you can completely omit these additional flags. Let's press enter. This will take a few minutes to complete, so go ahead and make yourself a cup of coffee. In fact, while this is installing, let me show you one of the simplest ways to install Langflow without having to manually create the environment, activate it, and install the dependencies. In the description of this video, you will find a link to this GitHub repo. And in this repo, you can find two files, run.bat and run.hs. These are scripts that I've written for my viewers, which will do everything in one go. So if you are using Windows, download run.bat, or if you're using Mac or Linux, you can download run.hs. So simply click on the file that you want And from here, click on Download Raw File. You can then move that file into any folder. And now all you have to do is double click this file. If you get this message, simply click on Run Anyway. And this will create the virtual environment for you. If it doesn't exist already, it will then activate the virtual environment and install or update Langflow. So if you do find the script useful, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Once installation is complete, we can start Langflow by running Langflow Run. You can then access Langflow by opening up this URL in your browser. And once you see this screen, it means that you've successfully installed Langflow and you can now start creating AI applications. Let's have a look at the Langflow UI. At the top of the screen, we've got these two menu options for My Collection and Store. All of our projects will show up in this My Collection page. On the left-hand side, we can view all of our projects and we can also create folders which we can use to organize all of our flows. We can also use the search box to search through all of our components and flows. And we can also filter based on flows or components. We can create a new flow either by clicking on New Project or Start Here. And we will do that in a second. We won't spend too much time on this, but we can also access a store. The store is useful for finding existing chat flows or templates, which we can copy and change as we please. We can also use the store to upload and share our own projects, which other people can then download and use. In order to use the store, you do need to be registered on the Langflow Store. Again, this part is optional, but I do want to show it in this tutorial series nonetheless. So we won't spend too much time on this. To access the store, you can go to langflow.org and then click on Store. You will then be prompted to either log in or register an account. I'll simply log in with my existing account. After logging in, we will see this dashboard, which we can use to see our existing flows. This is not to be confused with the collections page that we see on our Flowwise installation. Instead, what we can do is upload our flows to the store, and we can use that to either back up our flows in the cloud, and we can also choose to share our flows with the public. It is not possible to create flows using the store, but it's simply a mechanism to back up and share our flows with other people. We can still visit the store as per usual to see all the existing flows and components. But what is important here is we can go to Settings, we can then go to API Key, we can then copy our key, and then back in Langflow, we can click on API Key, we can then paste in that key, and click on Save. You will now be able to copy these template flows over to your own space. But if you don't have access to the store, then don't worry, as we won't spend any time on this. We can also go to our settings at the top right, and let's click on Settings. Here we can make some changes to the UI, but something that will become important later on are these global variables. We can use global variables to store sensitive data like API keys and some other information. But we will have a look at this in detail during this tutorial series. Let's go back to My Collections and let's create a new project. Here we can select to start with a blank flow or use one of the existing templates. We want to learn everything there is to know about Langflow, so let's start with a blank flow. How Langflow works is we won't write any code, but instead we will build our AI application by adding components and or nodes to the canvas. Let's first have a look at this dropdown. From here, we can select to create a new flow or duplicate this existing flow. We can click on Settings to change the name of our flow. So let's call this My Chatbot. Optionally, we can also give it a description. I'll simply clear this and click on Save. From this dropdown, we can also view logs. We can also import an existing flow. We can export this flow, or we can choose to undo or redo changes. We can also quickly navigate back to our collection or the store by clicking these menu items. On the bottom left, we can zoom in and out of the canvas or click this button to fit all the nodes into view. We can also lock the canvas, which means we will not be able to move around any nodes. We will use the playground feature to test out our application, and because we don't have any nodes on the canvas, we can't use this right now. We will also have a look at APIs, and we will use the APIs to call our application from outside of Langflow. We can also use the chat widget to embed our chatbot into something like a website. So now that we have Langflow installed, we are ready to create our very first AI chatbot.